Hello all. Welcome to the program Know Your Government by Neo IAS, an initiative where a government scheme is elaborated upon and is followed by a question in line with the UPSC pattern. Today we will discuss about a scheme which is known as the Smart Cities Mission. Now, what is Smart Cities Mission? Smart City Mission is an urban renewal and retrofitting program by the government of India. Urban renewal and retrofitting. So, two terms involved is, one is renewal up of the urban infrastructure, how the cities are looking like, as well as on retrofitting, which means from the present mode of how the city has been currently in, improvising upon that and improving upon the infrastructure is the idea of retrofitting. So, urban renewal and retrofitting program. The objective is to develop close to 100 cities in our nation as and qualify them as smart cities. So, the development of 100 smart cities is the key objective of the smart city mission. Then, the Union Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, in collaboration with the state governments of the respective states, is taking care about the implementation of the smart city program. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs plus the respective state government. Under the smart city mission, 100 cities in India has been envisaged to be developed for a period of 5 years, from a period of 2015-16 to the financial year of 2019-20. So, 5 years getting up this goal of 100 smart cities done is the idea of a smart city mission. We will see the features of this smart cities subsequently, what precisely are the characteristics of a smart cities. Then, the structure of the scheme is 50-50, wherein which the funding will be done on a 50-50 mode, wherein which both the center as well as the state government is involved up into. Now, the objective is to promote sustainable and inclusive cities, promotion of sustainable and inclusive cities, and to provide core infrastructure. So, sustainable and inclusive cities, helping in the development of core infrastructure of the cities, decent quality of life to the citizens of those cities, and a clean and sustainable environment, along with the usage of smart solutions, are some of the key core ideas in the smart cities mission. Now, we have heard the term about promoting core infrastructure. So, promotion of core infrastructure would involve proper development in these areas like electricity connection, sanitation, supply, water supply, urban mobility, public transport systems, IT connectivity and digitalization, good governance mechanisms through online modes, safety and security of the citizens, etc., to be ensured upon. So, what are we talking about? How or what are all the core infrastructure which needs to be taken care under the smart city mission? Development of electricity, road, that is public transport, IT connectivity, then digitization, good governance, ensuring that the city is safe for both women and children, and it is also safe for the, or taking care about the health aspects of the elderly people in the city is also some of the ideas envisaged. Then, the selection process of smart cities is done through a mode which is known as smart cities challenge. Selection of the smart cities. We know that, you know, we have to take 100 cities, and the 100th city which has been taken recently by the government is Shillong, and the selection of all these 100 cities has been done through a challenge which is known as smart city challenge. Smart cities challenge basically means that the respective government would come up with plans, or respective local governments would infuse upon plans to how they could effectively develop those cities. And these plans put forward by different governments would compete against the merit of this plan based on parameters. And based on the potential of those cities or this plan to be implemented, as well as about the quality of the plan, as well as about the vision of what all are the things, you know, which we could include upon, and about the practical feasibility is with the, or through with the central government finally comes up with the selection of these cities. And smart city mission is also implemented through a special purpose vehicle mode. Through an SPV mode is the implementation of smart city mission also done. So SPV mode means establishing or the development of the city is being taken care exclusively with new set of people, new set of machinery, which is not in line with the existing government machineries, and these new machineries are tasked with the development of this smart cities in the respective states. Then the strategic components of smart city mission would include: one, city improvement from the existing base, how the city could be improved upon, that is known as retrofitting. One is retrofitting. Next one is redevelopment, that is the developing up of a city by not depending upon the existing mode, how the city is being currently functioning up into, but scrapping it upon and starting is the idea of redevelopment. City extension, which means those areas which are closer to cities, may not be now the part of cities, are also planned to be developed so that it can accommodate more population in those regions. So retrofitting or city improvement, city renewal or redevelopment, and city extension, which is a greenfield development. So greenfield development means, correct, a new development mode or the development of a project right from scratch, as well as pan city initiative. So four strategic components include city improvement, city renewal, city extension, and pan city initiative. So pan city initiative is an idea where smart solutions are applied to larger part of the cities. Say for example, intelligent traffic systems, intelligent water management systems, etc., are employed upon so that sustainable mode of functioning of the cities is actually happening. Then some of the features of the smart cities would include housing and inclusiveness, to ensure that housing opportunities are given to all people or to more number of people, irrespective of the class, creed, strata of the society which they are belonging up into, is one of the idea. Creating walkable localities to ensure that in a city there are segregated mode for motor transport, for people cycling, for people to walk, etc., so that, you know, their health part is also being taken care. Then preserving and developing open spaces. So for the development of parks, playgrounds, recreational space, etc., is also envisaged under the smart city mission. Promoting a variety of transport options and transit oriented development, that is focusing upon the public transport, and that too on a last mile connectivity of that has been also happening, is to be ensured under the smart city mission. So transport, developing up of open spaces, creating walkable localities, as well as housing and inclusiveness about the construction of houses. Then making governance citizen friendly and cost effective. Say for example, to ensure that, you know, more mode of online governance mechanism is being done. Say for example, you know, you need a birth certificate, you need the death certificate. So probably in a known smart city, you have to go to the office, stand in queue, take time, it consumes a lot of time of yours. But instead of that, governance mechanisms are also envisaged to be done on a much more effective, faster, cheaper, sustainable mode is also a feature of a smart city. Then giving an identity to the city, depending upon what are all the core strengths of the city. Say for example, you take the case of Bangalore. That is one of the key feature of Bangalore is, you know, it is an IT predominant development oriented city, where which the IT industry is also on a predominant note. So perceive upon that. So those kind of an idea, focusing upon the core nature of the city, preserving upon that and moving on, is also envisaged under the smart city. So based on its major economic activity, you focus upon the low or one is the economic activity, also you could focus upon the identity of city in terms of its local cuisine, his health part, his education part, its art and craft part in that city, etc., can also be taken into consideration. Applying smart solutions to infrastructure and services. Say for example, making the areas less vulnerable to disasters. So to properly predict the occurrence of a disaster, etc., is also envisaged under the smart cities idea. except for West Bengal, except for West Bengal, almost all the other Indian states and union territories are participating in the smart cities mission by nominating a city. West Bengal has withdrawn its idea to participate in the smart city mission. Again, this is the first time, the Ministry of Urban Development program is using a challenge or a competition method to select cities. For the first time is when the Ministry of Urban Development is using a challenge method or a competition mode like a smart cities challenge to identify the cities which needs to be developed. Is being something, you know, which we need to note. And it is also focusing upon the strategy of an area-based development. Strategy of an area-based development means that you take the case of Delhi. So under smart city mission, this you can either develop the entire part of Delhi or probably one area of Delhi needs to be developed. Is also possible. So it means that not the complete development of city, but whereas at one area segregated development is also possible under the smart city mission. Then it is aiming at developing the entire urban ecosystem by residing upon four comprehensive pillars of development, that is institutional development, physical development, social development, as well as ensuring enough economic infrastructure in the nation or in those cities. We will see a question which is based upon the smart cities mission. It is an urban renewal and retrofitting program aiming to develop 500 cities across the country, making them citizen friendly and sustainable. So this, on a first glance, you know, this would look like this statement is true, but the catch is it is not about developing 500 cities, it is all about developing 100 cities, whereas it was Amrit, it was taking care of the development of 500 cities. Then, this is the first time a Ministry of Urban Development program is using the challenge or competition method to select cities for funding and using a strategy of area-based development. We have already discussed that, that this is the first time the Ministry of Urban Development is using a kind of a challenge method like a smart cities challenge, which is meaning first statement is wrong, second statement is right, and it is giving us the answer as option B. Two only. Thank you so much.